Okay students, now we are into the lecture of types of electrochemical cells or commercial cells. Okay, topic is commercial cells is the topic. Okay, so in commercial cells, basically electrochemical cells only. Okay, they are divided into basically three types. Basically how many types? Three types. Okay, first one is called as a primary cell. Next one is called as a secondary cell. Okay, next one is called as what? Secondary cell. Okay, then people will think that it will be tertiary cell, but it is not like that. Understood? Primary cell, next is secondary cell, third one is the fuel cell. Okay, fuel cell. So these are the three types of commercial cells is in syllabus and we are going to study. Understood? Now what is the difference between these three cells basically? You should know. Okay? So if a cell is single use, if an electrochemical cell is of single use, then it is called as a primary cell. That means once you use the electricity stored inside it as a chemical energy, you used as electrical energy once only, then you cannot use it again after charging. Okay, it is not simple language, it is not rechargeable. Understood? So it is of single time use, then that cells are called as a primary cells. The electrochemical cell which can be used only once, then they are called as primary cell. Okay, so but the advantage, the second cell is secondary cell. Okay, it can be used, then it will be all electrical energy will be consumed, that time it will act as a electrochemical cell, but again it can be charged, that time during that it is going to act as a electrochemicals electrolytic cell. Once you are charging, it is electrolytic cell. Once you are using it for electricity, then it is electrochemical cell. That means it is double role, dual role. Okay, it can act as electrochemical cell or it can act as electrolytic cell. This is what these two we daily use it. Okay, like if you use the pencil cell battery and normal cells which we use in the watches, mercury cell, they are all under the primary cells. Once they are discharged, we will throw it them. But the cell which we are using in the inverter, okay, what happens when electricity is not there? That time what happens? It will give you electricity. That inverter battery is acting as a electrochemical cell because it is using the chemicals and giving you the electrical energy. That is electrochemical cell. But when power supply you got restored, then that will take the electrical energy and store it as a chemical energy. That time it will be electrolytic cell. Same way mobile battery also rechargeable. So once you are not charging, that time it is electrochemical cell. Once you are putting on the chargeable cell, mobile is put on the charge, that time it will be electrolytic cell. So these are the secondary cells. And charging, discharging, nothing is required. Continuously you keep on pumping the chemicals, you keep on getting the uninterrupted energy. If you want, then better energy is fuel cell. Okay, so these are the three different cell. Here only discharge, you cannot charge it. Okay, you can charge and discharge, and once you use it further, it cannot discharge. It can continuously discharge without any recharge. Understood? That is the difference between the three types of cells. Is this understood? So first of all, we are going to study three types of cells here. Okay, three types of cells: dry cell, okay, second one is mercury cell, and very very short important topics are there, like why mercury cell is preferred in hearing aids, why it is used as a pacemaker. Okay, what are the disadvantages or care to be taken while disposing the mercury cell. Okay, now in dry cell, recently one modified dry cell is there. Okay, that will also I will write it as a modified dry cell. Okay, modified dry cell, is it understood? So then secondary cells are very simple. First one is what we use as a lead acid battery. Okay, lead acid cell, is it understood? Second one is nickel cadmium cell. Okay. So nickel cadmium cell. Apart from this, I will give you some example related to this. Okay. Because every day there are innovations in this type of cells only. These are not much used because everything is now replaced with the secondary cells only. Okay. Here only one example, hydrogen oxygen cell. But with that also I will try to give you some examples. So all must be ready with the notes and maintain the proper notes, maintain continuity in classes. If you miss one class, then it will be difficult for you to understand the other class. I hope all of you will understand the continuity, the advantage of continuity and maintaining the proper notes. Okay. And don't forget to like the video. If not like, do it now. Okay. So then shall we proceed? So before proceeding, note down these all things. Then we will keep on studying one by one. Okay. Only once we can use it, and once it is discharged, it is disposable. It can be discharged and again recharged. Need not to recharge. Continuously it will give you the continuous source of energy is fuel cell. Okay. How that it, what is the principle behind it, what is the anode, and I told you, I will ask you to make a short notes. Is it understood? Because this is the scoring topic. I want that everything should be on a single page. First you write elaborately. Then you know the importance of the points. How to write, I will tell you. Okay. So note down this table first, then we'll start with the one by one cell. Okay. Okay, the first one is the dry cell. What is the first one? It is the dry cell. Okay. In dry cell, first of all, what is cathode, what is anode, and what is electrolyte. In this short objective, direct objectives will be there. Okay. First of all, dry cell is made up of the, what is the cathode? Okay. The cathode of the dry cell is a carbon. Okay. Carbon means there are many allotropic forms which we will use graphite rod. Okay. Carbon rod or graphite rod act as a cathode. Okay. And it is surrounded by, very important thing is, it is surrounded by two things. Surrounded by two things. Okay. First thing is paste of MnO2. What is the first thing? Paste of MnO2. Actually, this is the part which is undergoing reaction. It is only to hold. Okay. Paste of MnO2. This is the part which is participating in the reaction. Okay. And powdered graphite. Powdered graphite. Okay. So, here this MnO2, as I told you, cathode, it will undergo reduction. Okay. How the reduction will take place, what will be the equivalent factor, that I am going to explain. Okay. So construction, in the first construction, cathode. What is cathode? Carbon or graphite rod. Okay. Suppose this is the graphite rod. Understood? Cylindrical shape it is going to be. And around this what it is going to be? Filled with the powdered graphite and MnO2. Okay. MnO2 is surrounded over all over here. And all over here, powdered graphite also will be there. Graphite will be rod also, graphite powder also. It will be filled over this. Okay. In between, you will find the paste of MnO2. This is the complete construction of the cathode. Okay. So, graphite is only inert electrode. It will not participate in the reaction. Its purpose is only to collect charge and give charge. If it is cathode, then it will collect the electrons and it will give it to the substance like here manganese. Is this understood? Cathode. Then anode is very simple. Anode is the zinc container. Okay. What is anode? Zinc is the anode. And third part, what I told you, electrolyte. In everywhere, while writing the short notes, we will specially emphasize these things. Okay. Electrolyte is the paste. Okay. What is paste you have to take, as I told you, dry. Earlier what they used to use is electrolyte. If it is a liquid, then spilling will be there. Okay. So to avoid that, nowadays it is taken in the form of the paste. Okay. Paste of ammonium chloride. What is that? Ammonium chloride. Okay. That too, moist paste. That means some water must be there. Moist paste of the ammonium chloride is electrolyte, zinc is anode, and cathode is carbon, but reactive part is what? MnO2. Okay? Note down these parts. Understood? So, as you are, if you want the diagram also, you can better draw as per the NCERT. Don't look here and there. Multicolor diagram is not required. But mostly the questions, if you write like this point wise in the board exams, you will get full marks. And in the entrance examination, it is useful for objective also. Okay, note down this. Then what we will study? What are the reactions? Already you must be aware, dry cell is electrochemical cell. So during at cathode, what it should do? It should reduce and anode should undergo oxidation. Okay. So, if that much knowledge is there, then more than sufficient. Okay. So, this you have written, dry cell, construction, cathode, anode, and what are the specialities? Moist paste of the ammonium chloride is electrolyte. Okay. So, now I will tell you reaction. Okay. First reaction, first what I will write at anode. Okay. What is the reaction? Reaction at anode. Understood? So, anode already you are aware, oxidation must be there and we have taken zinc as anode. And zinc does not show. One more objective is, zinc is a transition metal but does not show variable oxidation property. Being transition metal, it does not show variable oxidation property. It's only one oxidation state. What is that? 2 positive. Okay, this is anode. Now, reaction at cathode. Okay, in cathode what I told you, carbon will participate or MnO2 will participate? Very good, MnO2 will participate. Okay, MnO2 you find here, what is the oxidation number? +4. Okay, and it should reduce. For that it will take the help of the, ammonium. Okay, from where I will get ammonium? That is electrolyte, 2 moles of ammonium. Okay. Treated with 4 moles of water and these 2 electrons. Okay, the 2 electrons imparted from the anode react with paste. That's why I told you moist paste of ammonium chloride. Why moist is required? Is it understood? Water is necessary. Moist is water and ammonium chloride NH4 positive. Okay, so that all reaction will take place. Then this will be converted to MnOH whole twice. See here, before the reaction it was oxidation number was +4. Now oxidation number is +2. Is this understood? And this will be converted to, okay, this will be converted to hydrogens came up over here and OH will come, will see 4 hydrogens. Okay. And this will be converted to 4 OH will be there and 2. So 2 NH4OH. What it will be converted? 2 NH4OH. That is what the balance reaction is. Okay. So here 2 electrons on the left side, 2 electrons on the right side. So when I add both of them, net cell reaction. What I will get? Net cell reaction. Okay. In net cell reaction, we will have Zn and we will have 2 MnO2. Okay. And here it will be 2 NH4 positive, okay, plus all left side I am writing together, 4 H2O, okay, electron is getting cancelled and here it is going to be Zn2 positive, okay, and here it is going to be 2 MnOH whole twice, okay, plus 2 NH4OH, 2 NH4OH, is it understood? So note down these reactions completely. Very, very important, how many electrons it is going to lose, how many electrons going to gain, and what is the change in oxidation number. Many, many objectives will be derived from this equation alone. Okay, note down. Is that clarity is there? MnOH whole twice. Okay, MnOH whole twice, right side here. It is MnOH whole twice. Is it clear? So this is about the dry cell. Now we will start about what? Second primary cell. What is that? Do you remember? Very good. mercury cell. Okay, the mercury cell is the most compact and robust cell. Okay, so what you see in watches, this hand watches, wrist watches, what you see, they will contain this cell only. Okay, and they are very compact but robust. Okay, so we are going to start with the mercury cell. Are you ready? After dry cell, second one is mercury cell. Sorry, one more thing I forgot to write. In that 1.6 volt is the potential produced by the dry cell. Okay, note down, that is also important objective. 1.6 volt is the potential derived from the dry cell. Okay, okay. Okay, next one, what I told you, mercury cell. Mercury cell. Okay, in this uses, there are different types of questions are there. So, we will study it differently. Understood? So, before that, first what we should identify, what is cathode. Okay, so cathode here, what was before, if you remember, then it will be easy. Okay, here cathode is a paste of mercuric HGO, mercuric oxide, and graphite or carbon. Okay, paste of mercuric oxide and graphite is a cathode. Okay, then second one, what we have to remember, anode. Okay, anode is amalgamated zinc. What zinc? Amalgamated. Amalgam means it is a alloy. Okay, but alloy must be with mercury. Okay, amalgamated zinc is the anode, otherwise we can write it as Zn dash Hg. Okay, this is also solution. Is this understood? Next, electrolyte. Okay, what is the third thing you should remember? Electrolyte. Okay, electrolyte is paste of, again paste only, KOH plus zinc oxide. Okay, this is also must be in what? Paste. Paste of KOH and zinc oxide. Okay, for without forgetting, I am writing here only, it gives a constant voltage. Okay, constant voltage. What is the reason for constant voltage? Why I am specifying it here is, that is very important question. It is known for providing the constant voltage. Okay, anode, cathode, electrolyte, and voltage. Is this clear? Write down these three points, and with the most important, constant voltage also important. Okay, all total 4 points to write down. Then what we will do in the working, what is the reaction at anode, what is the reaction at cathode, what is the net reaction is more important here. After that, applications and advantages and disposal care. Okay, so note down this. Mercury cell, is it okay? Cathode, anode, done. Noted. If not noted till now, just pause the video and note down. Okay, let me complete it fast. Okay, so now let us see about the next reaction at anode. Okay, reaction at anode. What is anode? Amalgamated zinc. That means zinc only. Okay, so what zinc will do? Zinc will react with 2 moles of OH minus. Okay, it is along with the mercury only. Understood? Only to decrease the rate of reaction this is used, that's why amalgamated zinc. So it is going to form ZnOH hole twice. This negative charge will come out as a electron. Okay, so 2 electrons are emitted from the mercury cell. This is reaction at anode. Okay, next is reaction at cathode. What is the next one? Reaction at cathode. Okay, so in the reaction at cathode, what is the cathode? I told you, mercuric oxide. What is the reaction? Mercuric oxide. Mercuric oxide react with 2H2O. Okay, sorry, 1H2O only, and accept those 2 electron. Okay, accept those 2 electron will reduce. Here also mercury will reduce. In the previous one, manganese was reducing. Here mercury will reduce from plus 2 to 0. Cathode reduction, anode oxidation, 0 to 2 plus, plus 2 to 0. Okay, then what happens to this CH2 and this oxygen? will come out as a OH minus. Okay, here it is absorbed, here it is released. Is this understood? Now, when I add these two, this electron-electron getting cancelled, ion-ion getting cancelled. Okay, so Zn plus HgO plus H2O. Okay, will give you ZnOH whole twice. ZnOH whole twice plus Hg. Okay, Zn plus HgO plus H2O. Here you can, the previous one and this one, there is one the main difference. Okay, no ions are found in net reaction. Okay, no ions found in net reaction. This is net reaction. So once there is no ions in the net reaction, it will provide you constant voltage. That's why I is clearly written constant voltage. Okay, so what is the reason why mercury cell will provide constant voltage? Because net reaction does not involve any ions, so there is no concentration change. Ions are changing into, if they, you find any ions, like in the previous example we have seen NH4+. Okay, so in the net reaction also, if they are available, they are going to affect the voltage. Initially high voltage, slowly slowly that will voltage will drop. Okay, so but such problem is not found in the mercury cell. Is this understood? So because of this constant voltage only, this founds use in pacemaker. What maker? Pacemaker. Pacemaker means heartbeat. To maintain constant heartbeat, pacemaker is used. Okay, so this net equation I think you have written. Now let's see about the uses and advantages. Okay, first one, due to the constant voltage, as it is giving you constant voltage, it's found, it finds use in the pacemaker. Second thing, it is very compact in size. Okay, compact in size, and it gives a low current. Okay, low current, low current. Therefore it is used in hearing aids. Which aids? Hearing aids. Okay, hearing aids means if you are not able to listen, then you will get one some instrument that is called as a hearing aid. Then if it is heavy, then it will difficult for you to carry, and if it is big, then everybody will come to know that your hearing power is not good. So because of the compact size and low current, it finds use in the hearing aids. Advantages, is it understood? Compact in size, constant voltage and low current. So low current, compact size is used in, advantage is used in the hearing aids due to constant voltage. Due to what voltage? Constant voltage. It finds use in the pacemaker. Okay, so but only thing problem is disposal. Okay, what is the problem? Disposal. Okay, here this contains a mercury. Mercury is the poisonous metal. Okay, mercury is a poisonous metal, therefore it causes the pollution. What it causes? Pollution. Okay, that is only disadvantage. Mercury cell disadvantage is mercury being poisonous, it causes pollution. Okay, so disposal is very very difficult. This is about the second primary cell. Second primary cell. Okay, and one more thing I told you, what is that? Very good. Primary dry cell only, modified dry cell. Okay, that we are going to see, but differences you should remember. I will not point out the differences. Those students who maintained the notes from the beginning, they will understand the differences, what was there in that place you should identify. Okay, so let's start with the third type of primary cell, modified dry cell. Okay, okay, modified dry cell, otherwise we can call it as a alkaline dry cell. Directly I will write the reactions so that let us not waste the time, and now you are in a position to identify anode, cathode. Okay, so let's see here. Only thing, in place of the ammonium chloride, here alkali is used. What is used? Alkali, like KOH is used. Understood? There it was ammonium hydroxide. Now here it is replaced with the, sorry, ammonium chloride was there. Now it is replaced with the KOH. Okay, then that's why it is called as an alkali dry cell. Okay, so Zn plus 2OH minus, Zn plus 2OH minus, that which is produced from here, then ZnOH whole twice plus 2 electrons, plus what? 2 electrons, okay, then 2MnO2, okay, 2MnO2 gives plus 2H2O, okay, then 2MnOOH, very important formula, okay, 2MnOOH, is that understood? So the net reaction, if I write, I think you can clarity have here, this is oxidation, this is anode, MnO2 is undergoing reduction, cathode, okay. Net reaction, if I am writing, what should cancel out, sorry, electrons, here it will be 2 electrons, okay. So that electron will get cancelled out, understood. Net reaction will be, I am writing directly, Zn plus 2MnO2. Plus 2H2O, 2MnO2 plus 2H, this OH is here only, understood? Okay, 2H2O gives ZnOH whole twice, plus only this side it is 2MnOOH, 2MnOOH, this is the net cell reaction, okay? And if I forgot there also, so it is 1.5 volt, okay? This is what primary cells, okay. Secondary cells and fuel cells we will study in the next lecture, okay. Maintain proper notes and we'll meet you in the next lecture. If you are still not like the video immediately, okay. Bye bye, see you.